Defense Updates has reached more than 150,000 subscribers. We're genuinely thankful to our viewers. You keep us going. We don't dilute your video watching experience in this channel with sponsored products. If you like what we're doing, kindly support us on Patreon. www.patreon.com/defenseupdates. The United States Secretary of State Rex Tillerson has said that the U.S. is ready to begin exploratory talks with North Korea without preconditions, but only after a period of quiet without new nuclear or missile tests. The Secretary of State's remarks appeared to mark a shift in State Department policy, which had previously required Pyongyang to show it was serious about giving up its nuclear arsenal before contacts could start. And the language was a long way from repeated comments by Donald Trump that such contacts are a waste of time. North Korea has not yet shown any intent on backing down. Earlier this week, it emerged that China is building a network of refugee camps along its 880-mile, that's 1,416-kilometer, border with North Korea in preparation for a potential exodus that could be unleashed by conflict or the collapse of Kim Jong-un's regime. This development indicates the increasing probability of clash. One of the options that the United States is looking at to counter North Korea's nuclear-tipped ballistic missiles is an experimental weapon called CHAMP. CHAMP stands for Counter-Electronics High-Powered Microwave Advanced Missile Project. It uses bursts of microwave energy, an electromagnetic pulse, to disable electronic systems. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why the U.S. may use CHAMP to fry North Korea's missiles.
Number 5.
The idea would be to launch a cruise missile such as an AGM-86C, which is carried by the Boeing B-52, that's armed with a CHAMP warhead to disable Pyongyang's nuclear forces. CHAMP is like a super powerful microwave oven that can generate a concentrated beam of microwave energy. These high-powered microwave signals are very effective at disrupting and possibly disabling electronic circuits, Mary Lou Robinson, who heads the development of the weapons at the Air Force Research Laboratory, told NBC News. Missiles, bombs, etc. all have complex electronic circuits, so such an attack could actually disable them. The most important aspect is that it's not lethal for humans and will avoid human casualties. CHAMP is not yet ready for operational deployment and it could take a little bit of time, but officials believe the weapon could be readied for a contingency operation within only a few days of an emergency. And indeed, the US Air Force has tested the weapon against simulated facilities that produce weapons of mass destruction.
Number 4.
The Boeing B-52 Stratofortress is an American long-range, subsonic, jet-powered strategic bomber. The B-52 was designed and built by Boeing, which has continued to provide support and upgrades. It's been operated by the United States Air Force, USAF, since the 1950s. Superior performance at high subsonic speeds and relatively low operating costs have kept the B-52 in service despite the advent of more advanced aircrafts, including the variable geometry B-1 Lancer and the stealth B-2 Spirit. B-52 are powered by Pratt & Whitney turbojet engines. The powerful engines also enable B-52 to carry up to 70,000 pounds, that's 32,000 kilograms, of weapons and have a typical combat range of more than 8,800 miles, 14,080 kilometers. Without aerial refueling. This makes the B-52 an ideal launch platform for an AGM-86C missile armed with CHAMP.
Number 3.
The AGM-86 is a subsonic air-launched cruise missile built by Boeing. This missile was developed to increase the effectiveness and survivability of the Boeing B-52 bomber as the missile can be fired from standoff ranges. In combination, the missile dilutes an enemy's forces and complicates air defense of its territory. All variants of the AGM-86 missile are powered by a Williams F-107 turbofan jet engine that propels it at sustained subsonic speeds and can be launched from aircraft at both high and low altitudes. The missile deploys its folded wings, tail surfaces, and engine inlet after launch. Sophisticated guidance makes the missile very accurate. It has a range of 1,100 to 2,400 kilometers, depending on variant. This enables the B-52 to launch it far off from the target. A single B-52 can launch up to 20 of these missiles. Hence, an enemy force could have to counterattack more than one missile at a time, making defense against them costly and complicated. The enemy's defenses are further hampered by the missile's small size and low-altitude flight capability, which makes them difficult to detect on radar. North Korea has no air defense system which is capable of taking out this missile.
Number 2.
Though seemingly a silver bullet, with CHAMP there are certain disadvantages. 1. The weapons would have to fly exceedingly close to the North Korean missiles before detonating. 2. There is also the very real possibility that North Korean nuclear facilities are hardened against an EMP, just as American, Russian, and Chinese systems are. 3. If North Korea can detect the missile, it's likely they will try to shoot it down or respond as if it were a kinetic attack. North Korea won't know if or when it detects the missiles whether they're carrying CHAMP as opposed to a conventional or nuclear warhead. North Korea will see cruise missiles fly into the country and hear explosions. By the time they figure out they were less lethal HPM payloads, they will have already retaliated. So the situation will still escalate.
Number 1.
Keeping in view the limitations, CHAMP could be used by US in a scenario where it targets a specific missile site. But this could result in all-out war, just like it would with traditional options. In case of all-out preemptive strike by US, the CHAMP will certainly give way to tactical nukes or conventional weapons, as it will be essential to eliminate all of North Korea's nuclear weapons in one sweep, and CHAMP won't be suitable for that role. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.